Hey there, Alex here. This is the Moto Z2 Play, Motorola's second generation Z series phone. It looks very similar to their first generation devices, and it's for a good reason. The Z series supports Moto Mod, extra items that you can clip onto the phone for additional features, and Motorola promised 3 years of support for these mods, which is why the size of the phone, this huge camera bump, and these connectors are not going anywhere. I'll get back to the mods in a bit, but let's talk about design first. At a time where a shift seems to be happening when it comes to screen aspect ratios and bezel-less design, it's sort of an unfortunate timing for Lenovo, but that said, I actually like the way the Z2 Play looks. I very much prefer this metal backplate over the glass panel on its predecessor. Overall, it has a sharp and somewhat industrial look to it that I really like. I do have a few minor complaints though. I think that the side buttons are a little bit too small and hard to reach. Also, I'm a little concerned about how durable the glass on the camera bump is. I had a Moto Z and the coating on the glass picked up a few hairline scratches within the first week of use. On top of that, the phone is not rated to be water resistant, which is a little disappointing. There is a water repellent nano coating though, so it should be okay for minor splashes. Other than the minor changes in design, the front of the phone is pretty much as expected. You get a single front firing speaker which sounds decent, a 5.5-inch Full HD AMOLED panel which looks decent, and you get a fingerprint sensor at the bottom that is decent too. A significant change for the Z2 Play this year is the reduction in thickness. It's around 14% thinner than the Moto Z Play, but it also brings the battery capacity down by around the same percentage to 3000mAh. This might be somewhat of an unpopular opinion, but I've always found the Moto Z Play to be a rather chunky phone, even without any mods. And since battery life is still good, and a day of use is still easily achievable with a very efficient Snapdragon 626 chipset, I'm willing to give it a pass on this front. On paper, the main difference with the 625 last year is pretty much just a slightly faster clock speed, something that most people probably wouldn't notice in day-to-day use. In Singapore, we also get the version with a bit more storage and RAM, which is nice. So when you combine that with the relatively clean software that the phone is running, it amounts to a pretty enjoyable user experience. It will even handle games at moderate graphics settings with ease. Like past Moto devices, the software approach is a bit more restrained compared to say Huawei or Oppo, but I can definitely tell Lenovo is trying to insert more of their own flair into the software, like the minor icon changes, minor tweaks to the way things look, and some minor improvements to some of the features. You still get the basic suite of Moto features like double twist to launch the camera, double chop to activate the flashlight, and wave your hand across the screen to wake the phone. I can even reply messages by text or voice straight away on Moto Display, which is pretty convenient. Moto Voice got a new update too, which allows me to just say things like show me the weather or show me Instagram, and it'll just show me the information or launch the app. It's not really meant to replace Google's own voice assistant, it's just a simpler way of getting some basic information from the phone without the need to say OK Google every time. You also get this one button nav feature which combines all the navigation buttons into the fingerprint sensor with a combination of taps and swipes. I still prefer on-screen buttons just because they're easier to reach and it's easier to quickly switch between apps this way. One thing to note though, under Lenovo, Motorola's track record for updating their phones isn't really that great, so don't think that just because the software is quite clean, you'll get quick software updates. Being sort of a mid-range phone, the camera is expectedly decent, but not great. It's 12MP with a pretty decent setup in terms of pixel size, aperture, and autofocus. Images are decent looking for the most part with nice colors, but can lag a bit in dynamic range. The fast and accurate autofocus and the relatively decent auto mode makes it a pretty enjoyable camera to use. Low light is where it struggles a little with the lack of optical image stabilization. I found some shots with minor camera shake which is a little annoying, but other than that, the images are mostly decent enough for a mid-range phone. The phone supports up to 4K video recording but lacks any form of stabilization, so you're probably better off just using 1080p recording since it has electronic stabilization. The 5MP front camera comes with a dual-tone LED flash. It's useful when you're in a pitch-black location, but still want a selfie for some weird reason. It's not the best looking, but something is better than nothing. It's a little bit weaker when the lighting isn't great, but performs pretty well otherwise. So finally, let's get back to talking about the Moto Mods, the Moto Z2 Play's party piece. I get that clipping mods onto the back of the phone is really, really convenient. There's no need to deal with a charging cable from a power bank, or Bluetooth pairing with your wireless speakers. But how much are you willing to pay for that personal convenience? A typical power bank or Bluetooth speaker costs lesser and works with any other devices you or your friends have. I also haven't seen any Moto mods that can't be replaced by another standalone accessory. Even the 10x zoom from the Hasselblad mod isn't really that unique. I can definitely see some folks enjoying the conveniences that the Moto mods offers, and I do applaud Lenovo for trying something different, but I just don't think it's a killer feature, especially when you consider the prices of the mods. The good news is, the Moto Z2 Play is actually still a really good mid-range device, even without the use of any of the Moto mods. It does almost everything well enough, in a good-looking body that is razor thin. It's an enjoyable phone to use, and one that I actually really like. Just that, as a sequel to the Moto Z Play, it doesn't really offer much improvements. Also, this is not a cheap phone. In Singapore, the official retail price is SGD 799. You can probably get it a bit cheaper at other local retailers, but I just don't think it's worth buying considering I can get other budget flagship devices like the OnePlus 5 and Xiaomi Mi 6 at a cheaper price. Thanks for watching my review of the Moto Z2 Play. If you like what you saw, be sure to give me a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. Thanks, and see you guys on the next one.